Thanks for looking after my baby. I didn't want to leave her. I just couldn't cope anymore. Just not having Jeremy around. He was such a good boy. Can't understand why anyone would want to hurt him.
Do you take care of this baby on your own? Doesn't Jeremy's father live with you anymore?
He disappeared. The day after Jeremy. I don't know what happened to him. Maybe he couldn't take it. Ever since I've had to look after Emily all on my own, and I couldn't do it anymore.
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word, and there was just the cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah, I found a cell phone in his dresser. I'm sure it wasn't his. I'd never seen it before. I tried to turn it on, but it didn't work.
Do you still have it?
Yeah, it's in a drawer in the living room. You can have it if you'd like. I'm sure it's of more use to you than to me.
Do you have any family or anybody to help you?
Yeah. My mother. I didn't want to ask her for anything. We don't really get along. But I guess I'm out of options.
Well, look after yourself. And Emma.
I will. I promise.
I should go talk to the garage guy over there. Can't stop thinking about that well. Sean seemed exhausted. But at least he's alive. I'll do anything to get him out of there. The parking lot ticket and the origami figure leads to this garage. What am I going to find here?
Excuse me? Hey!
Oh! Huh! Sorry. Didn't see you. What can I do you for?
I'd like to get my car.
Hey, you're a pretty patient guy, you are. That car's been there for 2 years. We took it out for a drive every month and checked the tires and batteries, just like you said. Here, it's the third floor down. The service elevator is at the far end of the garage. You want them? They'll be right over there. Oh, you have yourself a good one, Chief.
Car's been here for 2 years. What does that mean? Elevator at the back of the garage, third floor. Got it.
Your destination is 4 miles from here. Leave the parking lot and take the first right. In order to save your son, listen carefully. Take the highway and drive against the traffic for 5 miles. If you haven't reached a destination in 5 minutes, you will have failed.
I don't want to die. Not here. Not like this. I can do it. I'd do anything to save my son. If I succeed, I'll get more letters for the hangman. It's my only lead. No turning back now. I've got to do it, for Sean's sake. I have no choice.
The reception. Let's hope they've got a room left. The reception. Let's hope they've got a room left. I'm worn out. I've got to sleep.
The atmosphere here is one of concern, as there is still no news of 10-year-old Sean Mars, who disappeared yesterday. A recent report indicates that the police are now treating this as another kidnapping by the Origami Killer. If this information is confirmed, he may still be alive, as the previous victims were all killed 3 to 5 days after their abduction. Obviously, time is running out fast for the investigators trying to find the child. I'm Michael Netty for ICN.
Hello there, sweetheart. What can I do for you?
I'd like a room.
For you? Anything. Feeling the register. Madison Page, 27, single. How long will you be staying with us, Ms. Page?
I don't know yet.
Room 201. Last floor, stairs on the right in the courtyard.
Thanks.
The pleasure was all mine.
That's for sure. Room 201. Stairs on the right, last floor. That obnoxious receptionist better not have a spare key to my room. The thought of it leaves me in a cold sweat. Room 201. Stairs on the right, last floor. There's someone there. Is he wounded? Maybe I should take a look.
Sir? Are you all right? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
Look, it's none of my business. I'll just leave him there and tell the receptionist.
Have you got the key? You're really in bad shape. You should see a doctor.
Must have one, maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. But it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep.
He's in trouble. I can't just walk away and leave him like that. I'll help him first and ask questions later. Medicine. There's bound to be a medicine cabinet in the bathroom. I should disinfect his cuts. I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. Sorry. Are you okay? There. At least I won't get infected.
Thanks.
Paracetamol painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours. Here. Take this. It should do you some good. It's a painkiller. It'll help reduce the pain. It says on the box to take one every 24 hours. I don't think it's a good idea to exceed the dose.
I can't afford to wait.
I wouldn't move around for a few days if I were you.
I'm gonna take a shower.
All right, let me help you. I'll wait here until you come out. Let me know if you need anything. Talk to me. That way I'll know if you pass out.
What's your name?
Madison.
Are you staying in the hotel?
No, I live in town. I suffer from chronic insomnia. I seem to only be able to sleep in motels. Don't ask me why. Whenever I get too exhausted, I come and spend a night here.
I'm just passing through. And what else do you do, Madison? Apart from fixing up strangers.
I'm a photographer. I take pictures of furniture for fashionable design magazines. And you?
I'm an architect.
Thanks for staying. I feel a lot better now.
Okay. I better get going then. By the way, you never told me your name.
Ethan.
Be careful, Ethan.
Why didn't you shoot?
Sorry?
Well, back there, Nathaniel could have had a gun. Could have killed me. Why didn't you shoot?
I prefer to have all the information before I make a decision. I try to make rational choices when possible.
Come on, you had a fraction of a second to react. You could have whacked me before you had time to move.
I'm sorry. I thought you were a tough guy. A street cop who's been through the mill. I didn't think you'd scare so easily.
Why don't you fuck off, Norman?
That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions. Shit, don't just stand there. He's gonna get away.
Ah! Hey, man, watch him! Ah.
Hey, what's the matter with
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
All the newspapers are talking about Sean Mars, the kid who disappeared. I needed the rest. I haven't been sleeping well since the murder started up again. I've seen the parents of all the victims. And all I've come up with is this telephone and a box of origami figures. I can't breathe this goddamn humidity. Hope it stops raining soon.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. You want a drink?
Yes, glass of water, please.
Take a seat, I'll get it.
Thanks. I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
It was mailed in the Carnaby district, the day before Johnny disappeared. Oh, nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation.
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous. And I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope. Maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? Big wood tycoon from Kramer Construction.
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers. Stupid to bring Lauren. I don't do partners too well. All that just to get my hands on that stupid envelope. Security guard earned his payoff. Seems there really is a party going on tonight.
Guy, I like you, my friend.
Maybe this job does have its perks. Now I got me a new friend. Whiskey straight up, no ice.
Hey, good looking girl. Keep your mind on the job, Scotty. Finding someone who isn't smashed or doped up to the gills would be a miracle. And I need one right now. Booze, babes, and coke. Gordy Kremer seems to be quite the party animal. Okay, gotta find Gordy Kremer. Don't know why they have that goddamn music so loud. Can't hear myself thinking here. Not gonna be easy to find Gordy behind that big wall of paid gorillas. Shake reinforcements around here. Got to find a way to get them away from the stairs long enough for me to be able to slip past. I'm at a dead end. Maybe I'll take a flyer on one of Lauren's ideas.
So, did you find Gordy?
He's upstairs. We've got two goons blocking the way.
Do you want me to handle them?
Hey, what are you gonna do? Knock them out with a pair of high heels?
Leave it to me! Just be ready to go as soon as they leave the stairs!
Wait, Lauren!
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You're giving me the crap now. Tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the Origami Killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
It might be a trap. I had better be careful. This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. What the hell am I supposed to do here? Now where am I supposed to go? There must be a clue or something. There's got to be a way into the building. The origami figure was in the form of a butterfly. So, am I looking for a butterfly?